Okay, so we're going to go through, we're going to sketch this problem on a position versus time graph. So position versus time. We're going to say that zero time is when the speeder passes the patrolman, and zero position is the spot on the road where the passing takes place. And then our speeder is just cruising along here at a nice constant velocity. And we know that that is only 20 meters per second, so a lowly 40 miles per hour here. And then our patrolman, it takes him 3 seconds after the passing. So when the clock says 3 seconds, then he is going to accelerate, and we're looking for where those two lines intersect each other. So we know it's a when and where do they meet problem, and we know that we're looking for the intersection of those two lines. So we're going to write the equation for these two lines. The equation for the position of the speeder, since it's a nice constant velocity, it's just going to be the velocity times the time. So it's just going to be 20 times t for the speeder. And then our patrolman, position of the patrolman, since he is accelerating, then it's going to be the entire first kinematics equation, except his initial position is zero, his initial velocity is zero. And then all we're left with is 1/2 his acceleration, which they tell us is 4, and then time squared. But since he didn't start when the clock started, he didn't start accelerating until the clock said 3, this is going to be t minus 3 squared. So we've got our two equations, and we want to figure out where those two things intersect each other. And you can do it with the algebra, but you can also use the graphing calculator to solve this. So we're going to go over and use the graphing calculator. So make sure it's turned on. We'll do it finding the intersection first. So we're going to click on y equals, and we're going to type in our two equations. So I'm going to type in 20, and then the variable button on the calculator, if you come down 2 from the top left, come over 2 and down 2, there's a button that says X, T, theta. That's your variable button. You hit that. That's my first equation. And then I hit enter. And my second equation, I'll go ahead and take 1/2 of 4, which is going to be 2. And then make sure you get the parentheses, variable minus 3, and then quantity squared. So I've got my two equations into the calculator. And I just wanted to find the intersection for me. So to do that, I'm going to tell it to graph. So I'm going to hit the graph button, and it's going to pop this up on the screen. Now, everybody's screen is probably going to look a little bit different. It depends on how you've got the bounds set. Really, what we want is we'd like to see the intersection on the screen someplace. What I tend to do is I'll hit zoom, which is the middle button underneath the screen. And since I put in equations, what works fairly well for me is if I go in and I tell it zoom fit, which is the last one on the list. If I tell it zoom fit, it usually will fit those equations decently well, so that I can at least kind of tell what's going on. The thing you have to be aware of, though, is you don't want to spend forever trying to play around with the zoom to get it to be really, really pretty. But you do want to try to get the intersection that you're looking for to be on the screen someplace. So can everybody kind of see the graphs on their screens at this point? I can't quite see that second intersection. Is yours not on there? It might be. We'll look at it in a second. If you can't quite see the intersection, I feel like it would be nice if I just zoomed out a little bit. So I'm going to hit zoom, and I'm going to go to zoom out. And then your little cursor, wherever you put it on the screen, will end up being the middle of the screen. So I'll go over here a little bit, and then I'll hit enter, and then hopefully I'll see that intersection on the screen. Okay, so there you go. I've got the intersection on the screen now. Notice there are two intersections of my curve and my line. I don't want the leftmost one, because that's going to be before the 3 seconds. That's going to be before the policeman starts moving. I want the one that's the farthest to the right. So to tell the calculator to get the intersection, above the trace button, it says calc. I'm going to hit second and then trace. So I'm trying to get to that calculate menu. And then number 5 on the list is intersect. I come down to that and hit enter. It's going to ask you first curve, second curve, and guess. First curve, the cursor will be on one of your lines blinking. You just want to hit enter and say, yes, this is the first one. Then it switches to the other one and you hit enter. If you don't have a whole bunch of equations in your calculator, if you only have two anyway, you can kind of just go enter, enter, because you know those are your two curves. The guess, however, is going to be more important now. Before, we had two lines, they only intersect once. Now we've got a curve and a line, there are two intersections. So when it says guess, you want to move your cursor so that it is closer to and maybe even past that second intersection, so that it finds that intersection first. It's only going to give you one solution at a time. You want the solution that makes physical sense, not the one that happened before the cop even started moving. So arrow on over on the gas and then hit enter. And then it comes back and it tells me on the screen, it says that the position is equal to 15.4. Actually, that's not position. That's what's on the x-axis. And you've got to remember that that is your time. So this is 15.4 seconds is the time. And then it tells me that the y is equal to 308.3. That's going to be meters. That's what's on your y-axis, which is your position when those two things meet. So what's really nice about the graph is you don't have to worry about getting time and then plugging it back in. It'll give both of them to you at the same time. And the biggest problem people have is just sometimes they have trouble with the zooming, and you really do need to have that intersection on your screen someplace for the calculator to be able to find what it is.